Hello, and today we are with Mr. Mario, well, Chef Mario Prestigiovanni, who is the executive chef of Four Seasons Chiang Mai. Good afternoon to you, Mario.
Good afternoon.
Now, you are very new to Chiang Mai, very new to the Four Seasons.
Yeah.
How long is it you've been here now?
1 month already.
Now, you've been to Muscat, you've worked in Muscat for quite a few years. You've been to China as well.
Yeah.
What are your impressions of Chiang Mai so far?
Chiang Mai is a nice city, small, but there are a lot of attraction, like all the temples and the market, night market, bazaar, no? And a lot of expat are here. You can see many expat around the city and make the environment really international, even if it's small as a city. Yeah, you can really can find the Western lifestyle at the same time the real Thai culture. This is really interesting. Yeah.
Right. Now, you are from a country which is passionate about its food. We're in Thailand, another culinary capital of the world. When you first arrive at a hotel like the Four Seasons Chiang Mai, what do you have to do? How do you set up your system of working at a hotel in a country with such beautiful food as they have in Thailand?
What I'm doing is just making my own style of food, you know, to propose to our guests in the resort, to the local people, not just Thai people, but there is a big community of expats here in Chiang Mai. What I want is prepare for them nice food, the really authentic Italian Mediterranean food, to let them enjoy their own, how can say, the flavor of their country, no? From there they come, no? Yeah.
Right. Now, what are some of your signature dishes? What are some of the dishes?
All made pasta, ravioli, you know, filled pasta, like cannelloni, but made in the, how can say, in the modern style, yeah. Because what I like is make traditional food, but I would like the people can recognize my own food, but twist in modern way, you know. Yeah, the presentation, to be attractive, nice looking, no? Yeah.
Right. Have you found any difficulty finding the right ingredients?
No, because I see you before, there's a big community of expats, and you can easily find all Western food items here in Chiang Mai. I'm really surprised, but this is really what I can see, no? The Western lifestyle is here, same to the Thai. Thai lifestyle, Thai, I can say, Thai culture, because we are in this country, you know. Yeah.
Now, Thailand is very well known for its cuisine, but within Thailand, just like in Italy, different regions have different types of food.
Yeah.
You, I believe, are from Palermo, which is where you went to university as well. How does food in Palermo differ from other parts of Italy?
Yeah, because in Palermo we like, since it's an island, we like prepare seafood dishes, and the food is more strong, more rich of flavor than the north of Italy, where the weather is different as well. It's more cold, especially winter time,
Right. Now, here in Thailand, there's a lot of local produce that you will be available to you very easily. You've also spent a lot of time in Muscat, almost over 4 years, in fact. When we travel as much as we do, and you especially as somebody that uses local ingredients, what have you picked up from Muscat and from China that you're going to be implementing here in Chiang Mai?
What I can do is it's completely different culture. Because Arabic, they imported everything from abroad. They don't produce nothing, they don't grow nothing in their country. It's just desert in Middle East, in the Gulf countries, especially Gulf countries. What you can learn there is open mind about the culinary food, the culture, no? You try to put something even in the Italian cuisine or Mediterranean cuisine, made more, I can say, more different influences, no, not just Italian, but could be, how can say, Arabic as well, because the taste is there. No, they use too much eat bread. They used to eat to eat like ground meat, like kebab. You know, this is really Mediterranean. No, yeah.
Now the Four Seasons Chiang Mai is aimed and accustomed to dealing with very exclusive clientele, yeah. Very discerning clientele. They demand the best.
Yeah.
And of course their restaurant, your restaurant, yeah. Is available to them. But one of the most exclusive parts of the hotel is the chef's table.
Yeah.
Could you tell us where is the chef's table and what do you plan for the chef's table? Is there a maximum number of people? How does it work, your chef's table?
My chef's table is in at the Terraces restaurant, our Western restaurant. We do previous booking, the chef table. We do some food from Italian region. We picking the food from north, center, south of Italy. Depend on the request of our guest, what they like. Maybe they like to have one team night with northern food rather than center or south food, you know. What I'm doing is prepare special menu for them, after sit to the table with them and discuss about the food, let them enjoy even a nice culinary experience.
Right.
Yeah.
Now some hotels, some five-star hotels, yeah. Even here in Chiang Mai, they have an even more exclusive chef's table, yeah. Which is in the kitchen.
Yeah.
Where it's full of surprises. Do you offer such a thing here at the
hotel? Yeah, we have a nice cooking school, you know. Where usually we do Thai, we teach to our guests the Thai food, how can make Thai food. And even there, sometimes can happen guests request to learn how can make some Italian or Mediterranean food. I will prepare the food for them. I will show them. I will teach them. I will let them try to make it by themselves, like we're doing with the Thai cooking school. Yeah, this is what we start to doing here. Yeah.
One of your first introductions to Chiang Mai society, yeah. Is happening, I believe, in a week's, yeah. Time. You're having a wine dinner, your first, yeah. Wine dinner. What do you have planned for that special occasion?
What I want to do is make a nice food, of course. Where I can show what is my culinary style, where the people can appreciate my work. This is the best way to introduce myself to the Chiang Mai community. You know, it's like showcase my professional background. I want the people know me here in the city. Come to our restaurant often to enjoy, you know, our food. No, this is what I plan to do. I want the people appreciate the people come here often. Yeah.
Now it is a wine dinner. What, yeah. Wines do you have planned for the evening?
The wine is a Tuscany wine. Wine from Chianti, and because the Chianti is the region in Tuscany where we do this team night, like wine dinner night, based on the Tuscany cuisine, and we pairing the wine in according to the food, of course. Yeah, like Chianti, because we have red wine to match it with some lamb. Yeah, or duck, and we have some starter where we can match it with some Frescobaldi wine, like Chardonnay. Yeah.
Right. Excellent. Well, I have to say thank you very much indeed for your time today, Mario. I know we've dragged you away from the kitchen today, but thank you very much. And of course, I wish you and of course the Four Seasons Chiang Mai the best of luck for the future.
Thank you very much.
Grazie mille.